what a saying really isn't believing. Over the years, visual evidence has been the unassailable gold standard to prove that something happened. But that's not really the case anymore. Deepfakes have really muddied the picture. The term deepfake is a combination of deep learning and fake, and is basically a Photoshop job on steroids. As long as the deepfake algorithm has enough data, enough footage essentially, of an existing subject, someone else can use the tech to manipulate that video and make it look like the person is saying or doing pretty much anything. When it's just Nick Cage, no big deal really. When it's world leaders, that's a little bit different.
We're entering an era in which our enemies can make it look like anyone is saying anything at any point in time, even if they would never say those things.
For now, deepfakes are impressive, but still not quite good enough so that they're undetectable to the naked eye. Though most agree it's only a matter of time until you won't be able to tell if it's a deepfake or an original. And when that time comes, how do we ensure that the things that need to be accurate representations of what happened really are? There's a growing movement to develop complementary tech that will help maintain that layer of trust between people and the media they consume. This is Shamir and Roderick. They started a company called Amber.
Amber is on a mission to address fake video. Fake video is not just dangerous in and of itself. Fake video will delegitimize authentic, genuine recordings. And Amber is to try to build that middle layer to say, hey, this has been a malicious alteration in the audio and video.
To do that, Amber has developed both detection and authentication technology.
The detection side is software that is looking at video tracks, the audio tracks, and looking at aspects within them for signs of potential malicious alteration.
We can analyze certain patterns that are unavoidable whenever you're altering a piece of video. We can actually train an artificial intelligence to pick up on these as it gets exposed to more and more fakes. It can learn and become better.
The problem with detection is it's strictly reactive. Amber's Authenticate is designed to ensure accuracy from the moment a video is being recorded.
Authenticate works such that it runs on the camera itself and it fingerprints the video as it's being recorded and then writes those fingerprints to a blockchain record. A blockchain is really a transparent yet immutable, unchangeable database. It's basically a database where anyone can look at, yet no one can rewrite, no one can edit a record.
There are a lot of potential applications for Amber's tech, but one that's particularly compelling is when it comes to police-worn body cameras.
One of the areas in which Amber Video is looking at, we're concerned around due process. If you look at, for example, police body cameras, when there's a situation, footage from the camera becomes evidence, and that evidence is shared with numerous stakeholders. And each one of them can check a record in the blockchain and have confidence that nothing has been altered.
So say you have a 2-hour video from a body-worn camera, and you make a 1-minute clip because of an incident that you want to document. That 1-minute clip will generate the same fingerprints that you would find in the original video.
Technology is not good or bad, it's how it is used.
I think now we need to take action to decide which way it goes. And for me, I'm personally motivated to make this technology a force for good.
If you like this video, don't forget to subscribe to Freethink for more great videos every week.